I'm talking about the role of carnitine and micronutrients in ovulation process. So infertility is defined as the failure to conceive a recognizing pregnancy after 12 months of unprotected intercourse. So we know that in the last decades the incidence of it is growing. 10 to 15% of couples have problem in conceiving, and also the rate of abortion is growing as well. So we know that targeting female infertility, we can target different processes like fertility, pregnancy, and reproduction that reflect different districts in the body, like ovary, uterus, and also the central nervous system. With the previous presentation, also we know that there are metabolic compromise and hormonal compromise, and altogether reflect some different processes like nutrition, or metabolic disease condition, age, and toxins. So our hypothesis is that L-carnitine and acetyl L-carnitine and micronutrient supplementation will improve the metabolism and hormonal profile. So give a look with the ovulation process. Here you can see a view that compared the young and the old ovary in mice. You can see that young ovary is full of follicles, while the old ovary is like atrophic tissues. And in the last decades, it's known that the ovary quality decline with age and with some pathological syndrome like polycystic ovary. How we can improve the oocyte quality. We know that folliculogenesis take a long time. The oocyte development process take like 375 days. And we now have fertility drugs that enhance the ovarian activity. But we have not some drug or therapy that improve the quality of this oocyte. We know that mitochondria are the central player in the metabolic process because they have a key role in different cellular processes, most of all are involved in producing energy. This is a schematic view in which you can see in particular that carnitine acts like to transport the active form of the free fatty acids through the mitochondrial membrane, where the beta oxidation reaction takes place. So what's happen if we have no beta oxidation reaction, no carnitines? The consequence is that we have no production of energy. And in terms of fertility, this means decrease in oocyte quality and in blastocyst number, decrease in fertilization, decrease in blastocyst development, increase in development disorders and embryo loss, and also increase in aneuploidy. Literature provides a large number of papers that demonstrate the role of the carnitines and also the beta oxidation reaction in the embryo developments. Here, the authors show that the inhibition of beta oxidation reaction with etomoxir give a decrease in the percentage of embryo development. And also here in the graph A and B, you can see the role of specific carnitine. In the graph A, it's shown the role of carnitine in improving the maturation of oocyte in vitro with serum. And in the graph B, it's shown the role of carnitine in improving the embryo development. So the aim of this preclinical study is to assess the best dietary combination of selected nutrients with carnitines and their effect on oocyte quality and quantity. So we use animal, in particular mice, and we divide the mice in four different groups. Here you can see in the table that the group number one is the control group, in which the treatment is only with the Vicol, that was water. The group two, the mice were treated with carnitine and that concentration. The group three with zinc, copper, and iron, and the fourth group is the combination between carnitine and zinc, copper, and iron. So mice were treated for 3 weeks with intragastric administration on these compounds. After 3 weeks, superovulation was induced and oocyte was collected. And at this point of the experiment, we are able to assess the quantity of oocyte, just to count the oocyte, and assess the quality. After that, we performed some in vitro fertilization experiments and evaluated the pre-implantation development. So the first results showed that carnitine treatment alone or in combination with iron, copper, and zinc has a positive effect on oocyte quantity. In fact, you can see that we have the major number of oocyte in the group number 2 and 4. And also carnitine treatment alone or in combination has a positive effect on the degradation rate because we have a decrease in oocyte degradation. At this time of the experiment, with a simple microscopic observation, we can distinguish the bad oocyte from the good oocyte because some morphological aspects. But to be sure of these results, we staining the oocyte with the DAPI that stain specifically the DNA of the cells. So you can see that in normal oocyte, we can look at the metaphase. The DNA is compacted. Meanwhile, in the degraded oocyte, the DNA is fragmented and is spread all over the cells. And this can indicate also an apoptosis process. And this is the final results that is, in my opinion, the most important because we show the percentage of blastocysts versus two cells embryos. And the group treated with carnitine show the higher percentage of embryos and their capability to reach the last stage of pre-implantation embryos. So in conclusion, we can see that carnitine treatment alone or in combination with zinc, copper, and iron has a positive effect on oocyte quantity, that carnitine treatment alone or in combination with zinc, copper, and iron has a positive effect in oocyte quality, and despite not showing a substantial increase in fertilization rate in respect to the control group, carnitine alone treatment showed the major rate of embryos that reach the final stage of pre-implantation development. Now we are ongoing with the activities and we are analyzing the second part, evaluating the role of carnitine on embryo development in in vivo fertilization experiments, comparing old and young group of mice. And also we are performing some gene expression analysis of specific genes that I marked with red that are involved implicated in different processes like ovulation, implantation, luteal differentiation regression. So just to see if there are some modification in the expression of these specific genes. And I also want to show you some paper that show the effect of carnitine on genomic stability. So there is an increase in meiotic spindle abnormality and aneuploidy due to the age lead increase in fertility, miscarriage, and trisomic conception. And there is a big problem because with no strategy to sustain oocyte quality with age or in general, and the L-carnitine supplementation reduces the oocyte cytoskeleton damage and embryo apoptosis. So I want to thank you, all of you, for your attention. I want to thank the Professor Ashraf Firmani and my colleagues, Dr. Cristina Cossetti, that work with me in this project, M Association and the Italian National Institute of Health, where animal experiments were performed. And finally, Sigma Tau, to give me the possibility to work in this field. Thank you very much.